Moroka Swallows will have to beat Orange-Vaal Professionals in their last match of the ABC Motsepe League on Saturday to avoid possibilities of being relegated to that dreaded fourth division next season. Now the Dube Birds go into the last match of the campaign, sitting dangerously second from bottom, and a defeat will almost see them relegated to amateur ranks next season, completing what has been quite a free fall over the past three seasons. Joining me right now, Timmy Maranda, ABC Motsepe League analyst. Timmy, welcome to Sports and Prime. That intro that I just read now, I sit back as a sports person, as a football person, when you speak of Swallows and you speak of ABC Motsepe and possibility of going down to fourth division, it's not what South African football, the history where we come from, as far as that's concerned.
In fact, we are saying they are the second oldest team in South Africa after Orlando Pirates. Mm. They were formed 10 years later. And the Moroka Swallows being one of the clubs that got so much rich history in South African football. When you talk about Moroka Swallows, not only are we talking about a football club, but a team that people from Soweto could relate to. When you talk about the original derby, it's between...
It's almost a movement, if you're
exactly my point. You know, it's the Kaizer Chiefs and Orlando Pirates derby, it's the biggest one. But at the end of the day, I think the original derby, for me, it's Orlando Pirates versus Moroka Swallows.
I mean, we're going to get to the fact that, you know, they're sitting dangerously close to going down to that, I mean, fourth division. That's not even football anymore, to be honest. Because, as you said, Swallows has got a great history. Where did it go wrong? Where did it go so pear-shaped for such a huge team? I mean, a brand such as Swallows. Where did it go wrong?
Tabi, so just funny enough, 5 years ago, I remember when they made an announcement under the leadership of Leon Prince. Soon after, I think the problem started when the late Dieter Bock, ownership problems during that time. Leon Prince took over, and it was just the same thing happening as far as ownership is concerned. It also continued when the consortium took over. I remember earlier on in this season, when the season started, there were two Moroka Swallows that were registered with the South African Football Association because they were just fight of ownership. Since they resolved the problem, when they managed to register the players, it also became evident that there is more problems than what we are led to believe. And the team managed to sign the players this first week when the season started in Tabi. So what actually happened is that Swallows started to conduct the trials on that week. And you remember in the ABC Motsepe League, you cannot kick off any game without the balance of the South African under-23 players. Yeah. So if you don't have this five under-23 players, no match will go on. So they were forced to then try to fast-track that process, get those players, get on with the progress of the league. Unfortunately, the players they acquired, they didn't understand the dynamics of playing the ABC Motsepe League, because that league, like we said, it's the difficult league. It's not easy. They don't give you space to breathe. It's just so competitive. So I think that's ownership for me has been the problem that led to where Moroka Swallows is currently.
Let's come back to the ABC Motsepe League. I mean, again, it's quite astounding that we speak of Swallows being in that league. But rightfully so, as you said, it's not child's play. I mean, we might think of it as being third division, but there are kids in there. And I said that one team surprised my team. I can't say on air which team mine is, but it's tough down there. It's really tough.
Certainly. And I mean, a testimony to that. Look at the Nedbank Cup currently. You know, we've got Kwadugusa, a team that comes from Norway, and no one knows about the team. They are currently in the last 16 of the Nedbank Cup. So it's also Akon Bush. They actually beat the Telkom Knockout Champions, you know, Cape Town City. And that, for me, it tells you that ABC Motsepe League is one of the biggest and the best hub as far as development is concerned in South Africa. And the success story, there are just too many. We don't have enough time. I can speak the whole day. But there's just so many players that have moved from the league, going into the National First Division, eventually into the to the PSL. And talking about Moroka Swallows, they produce a player who scored, Jomo Kunene Mkolisi. Yep. He came from Moroka Swallows, the one who scored against Kaizer Chiefs. So there's just so many stories to talk about.
So in all honesty, as you're saying, we probably don't give them much fairness or accolades, and as far as the media is concerned, we don't give them as much coverage as we would, as you just saw now, Chiefs or Pirates or Sundowns.
Tabi, so we dedicate our life covering the uncovered, because there's no television rights there. In fact, a lot of media don't even go and cover this kind of games.
Yeah.
Hence, earlier on, I said to you off air to say, people were even going on to switch off the machines for Moroka Swallows, saying that they're relegated. And as much as I'll be the first to admit that they are on life support, but I think we must give them a chance to play their last game, like you said in your intro, playing against Val Professional over the weekend. Only then we'll be able to say Moroka Swallows are relegated. But up to so far, let's give them yet another day to still live.
While speaking about that league in itself, Swallows obviously one of the bigger names, so to speak, in there. You cover it. I mean, you're an analyst in that particular league. shed some light on it, and as far as our viewers here on Sports and Prime. What are we missing instead of watching the PSL? What are we really missing?
In fact, for the past 2 years, Tabi, so I don't even go and watch Soweto Derby because I pretty much know the final results, you know.
draw by draw.
Exactly. But, you know, just to be honest with you, Tabi, so one thing that I know about the ABC Motsepe League, that you got coaches there, they're brave. You know, you don't find your so-called 4-5-1 formation where people are defending for the whole games, and we talk modern football, defensive approach, transition. We don't know that transition in the ABC Motsepe League. What then happens, we even see tactics that are being applied in the top level. Currently, if you look at the England team, they are playing three at the back.
Yeah.
I don't know of any team in South Africa that's playing that kind of formation. Yeah. But in the ABC Motsepe League, it's about attacking.
It's about flair.
It's about flair. It's about the excitement. And our identity is well represented in the ABC Motsepe League. Hence, we have seen some of the teams going as far as the last 16 of the Nedbank Cup. I think that is a testimony.
Then it's all lost all of a sudden when they, I say lost in inverted commas, when they move over and progress to second division and then the Premier League as far as it's concerned, because there we don't see that.
We don't see that at all. In fact, I can even go on to give an example with our junior national team, yeah. South African Football Association. Under 17 has qualified for Chile for the World Cup. With under 23 qualified for Brazil.
Yeah.
And of course, under 20 currently qualified for South Korea to go and play in the recent AFCON under 20 in Zambia. And somehow when we go to the national team, the senior national team, that is, we kind of like lose that identity. For me, I think we need to learn from how these youngsters are doing it, and they manage to qualify for big events, mm-hmm. yet the national team is not qualifying. Somewhere we are missing our identity, our philosophy, mm-hmm. as a football country.
Make a valid point right there. I mean, something obviously we have to pick up. Before we run out of time, Tim, promotion, and as far as ABC is concerned, what does it look like at the top of that league?
Yo, it's hectic. This weekend it's even going to the wire. It's April Fools. And tell you what, it's going to be exciting because Maccabi are currently on top of the log, mm-hmm. 1 point ahead of the second place and third place, who are both on 58 respectively. In this case, I'm talking JDR Stars and also Orange-Vaal Professional. Yeah. And I must mention Orange-Vaal Professional, the odds were saying 5,000-1. Nobody gave them a chance. And they are currently second. They got a chance to even claim the title.
But we want them to lose against Swallows, so the Swallows doesn't go down. How?
Yeah, that's what people, most of us were saying, let Swallows survive because of the rich history that they have.
Yeah, yeah.
But realistically speaking, they're playing against a team that is very strong. It's playing for their life. They've been fighting relegation for the past three seasons. But
and
this
now
year,
they've got a chance to actually go on and win the league.
Exactly. And the new coach has come through there, Isaac Mpasane.
Yeah.
I call him the Claudio Ranieri of this league. He surprised a lot of people, you know. But he's facing a tough competition against Undi Cheni, the Masisi of JDR Stars, who's got the pedigree, who has won this title last season and can still go on to defend it. But also, Uke Nindlas, who's coaching Maccabi, he has been there. He has done it. He's got a tie to prove it.
Yeah.
And he's, of course, coaching Swaziland, the South African under-23 national squad. So he's got a good pedigree to actually win this.
My editor says we can go on for a couple more seconds. SAB Regional League, what do you make of that?
Yo, a point of no return.
Yeah.
Any team that get related there to go there, the chances of coming are very slim. And I will tell you why, because there's a regional league, you go to provincial playoffs. Unlike in the ABC Motsepe League, where you win the league outright, you go to the playoffs, you get a chance to go to the national first division.
Yeah.
But SAB, so it's just a difficult way to come back.
Yeah.
A point of no return, I call it.
Yeah, so hopefully, as you said, I mean, unfortunately, somebody's got to go at the end of the day. Mm. Hopefully, and you said Super Sport, hopefully Swallows survive and then they don't go. But as you said, they're going to find it tough up against Vaal Professionals. Timmy, thank you for joining us right here on Sports and Prime. Much appreciated. Obviously, we're going to like to have you back. Obviously, talk about the outcome of this, of the league, and what it means, and hopefully Swallows does stay. I know a lot of our viewers would definitely, I personally, like to have them stay as well.
I would love to come back, and thank you so much for affording the opportunity, and big up to everybody who supported the ABC Motsepe League this season. Thank you.
Timmy Maranda, thank you very much for joining us on Sports and Prime. We take a quick break right here on Sports and Prime. When we return, we speak all things rugby, Super Rugby weekend. I know somebody's speaking about the Stormers, but I kid you what, the Sharks, they've been winning. Eh?